Now the next speaker for this webinar is Mr. Ravi R. Gokhale. So I would like to introduce Ravi R. Gokhale, and actually I am feeling very proud to introduce Ravi R. Gokhale because Mr. Ravi is my classmate. We were in MSc Part 1 and Part 2, and Mr. Ravi has the near about 20 years of industrial experience. Initially, he worked as a senior microbiologist in Ajay Biotech, Pune. That is joined in March 2003. Then after that, he worked as a quality control microbiologist in Pregna International Company. Then Mr. Ravi is approved microbiologist by Food and Drug Administration, and specifically for microbial testing and sterility testing of intrauterine devices. Then later on
Also,
he joined.
hello.
After that he joined Serum India Institute in 2007 in BCG vaccine production. Then he rejoined Ajay Biotech in 2010 as a production manager, and in same company he promoted as a factory manager. And now Mr. Ravi is running his own company in Pune, and the name of that company is that is mainly involved in the production of biofertilizers, biopesticides, plant growth promoters, and micronutrients. So on the way producing these biofertilizers, biopesticides, Mr. Ravi and his team and his company contributing to the eco-friendly way for the sustainable development of the farmers, and decreasing the pollution also by this way. So he running his own company by the name Tricon Biochem Corporation in Pune. So I would like to invite Mr. Ravi. Actually, again, I am proud feeling. So we are classmates, and the topic for Ravi is industrial skills and knowledge skills and knowledge required for the industrial jobs. So friends, I welcome to Mr. Ravi Gokhale to give a valuable speech. Thank you. Mr.
Thank you,
Ravi.
Santosh. May I audible to you? Hello.
हाँ, यस यस ऑडिबल रवि, यस ऑडिबल.
ओके, थैंक यू. फर्स्ट आई वुड लाइक टू वेलकम ऑल द डिग्निटरीज. दे आर स्पेशली फ्रॉम एकेडमिक्स. दे आर जायंट्स इन एकेडमिक्स. सो आई वेलकम यू ऑल. I would like to thank Mr. Dr. Lahane sir, then Uncle sir, Rajendra sir, and so today I will just tell you what skill or knowledge you required when you are going to apply for any, or we can say any biopharmaceutical industry. So today is the day of insulin, remembrance of Louis Pasteur, and as you know, he is very much keen on his work, like a vaccine, microbial fermentation, and pasteurization. So these three things in 18th century he done. But it is today applicable for us right now to enter in any biopharma or pharma. Dr. Deshmukh sir has already told you that you need people need a quality control or quality assurance people for the different type of testings and different type of testings of materials and all those things. So, first of all, the fermentation, I will come to the scheduleum. What is scheduleum? So it is good manufacturing practices for the all microbiologists or all pharmacologist people in Indian pharmacopoeia. So it is one of the schedule in which we'll have to accordingly we'll have to work. So if you want to work as a microbiologist in any pharmaceutical or biopharmaceutical company, you will have must you will have this knowledge of basic knowledge of schedulium. Okay, I will share the detailed schedulium with Professor Napte. He will give it to you later on. But generally, in schedulium, it is described how should be your company, how should be your clothing, how should be the air handling units. Air handling units is a very important aspect in a pharmacological companies, in which the sterile air is continuously pumping in the units, and different sort of areas are maintained over there, like a class A, class B, class C, and class D. These four classes are major classes in schedulium, in which we'll have to work, and we'll have to monitor the each aspect of environment. So we are allowed some. There is some allowation of a bacterial colony. If there is not, then in which area it is not. So it is like a whole, it will take a lot of time to you understand, but very briefly I am telling you, the area A is called as a area A, in which you are allowed only 12 to 10 microbes for 2 hour settling plate. That is very important aspect in all this thing, in which you can do your day-to-day aseptic work, like media transfer or media fill, and it should be carried out in a very aseptic manner. In area B, you are allowed approximate 295 5 micron size particle, which is very critical to attain, but we have to monitor those things, and we have to do the jobs accordingly. And area C and area D, we have somewhat leisure in it. So say about 2000 approximate 5 micron size is allowed in area C, and in area D, near about 30,000 particle are allowed. When I used to say particle, it will be a living thing or non-living thing below 5 micron size. That you should understand. Likewise, the schedulium, another thing is that After area monitoring, the garment and sanitization is a major aspect. For garment size, you will have in area B and in area A, you will have to wear full gowning. You can say the dungri and all those things. You are fully protected. Your any body part is not open to air. And in area C, you might have been seeing a lot of people using just half shirts and limb free clothes. That is allowed in area C. And normally in area D, you know, all this only apron is necessary in area D. In sanitization, you will have to sanitize the whole laboratory in means every day, and once in a week you will have to clean the walls of laboratory. And in every month you will have to clean walls as well as ceiling of the laboratory. And it was monitored by us by contact plate method or by taking a swab. So we will have to maintain the bacterial load accordingly. The second thing is that after sanitation, the equipment comes. In equipments, there are various process equipments and all those things. So you will have to take a swab of that. You will have to monitor the particular bacterial load or fungal load in that area. next thing comes in the water and water systems. So as you know, sir already told, if you got a contaminated water with a Vibrio, but it is a clean, that is very good example given by sir. We should need a very clean water. That water is called as a water for injection. So that water we need to use for all making of sanitizations and equipment cleaning and all those things. What a tedious process, and it is give up a whole idea for people to understand. Next comes the product containers and closures. So the quality control of a product has been done in a schedule M. Closures also done in schedule M. So this is regarding about bird view, we can say bird view of a schedule M. In schedule M, we can understand how to run a factory, how to do our day-to-day job, daily jobs for a microbiologist, differential pressure testings and other things also. So next point is come when you go to any industry for interview or whatever. So you have basic knowledge. You should have a basic knowledge of sterilization. So it should. You people already might have been known for sterilization, steam sterilization, dryer sterilization. These basically two major sterilization system used in all sort of industries. Next one is a media preparation. You should know how to prepare the media, what water we should use, what quality of water we should use, what is a making volume, what is a pH adjustment and all those things. So this basic knowledge you should have in that. I'm not going in deep detail inside that. Next thing is fermentation. In fermentation, majorly, if you are going in a industry like us, biofertilizer, we have very small shaker. From that shaker, we shifted our material to a large fermenter as per the orders. So it is, we have a near about 4,000 KL capacity fermenter over here in production unit. So one should understand what is the requirement of fermentation process. If you are going in a biofertilizer unit, you should know the biofertilizer strains properly and what we should use and all those things. As well as you should know how to do the pre-sterilization volume in a fermenter, how to adjust post-sterilization volume, the pH adjustment in a fermenting, because it need aseptic conditions and you need a very good aseptic hand and skill for that. You should also know the downstream process in fermentation technology. If you are visiting, if you are going in a biofertilizer sort of thing, you need in downstream some vacuum tray dryers or air dryers or centrifugation for the isolation of cell mass from the liquid or broth. That is very important factor in it. So if you are going to, if you are moving to any company or going for interview, you should have check first that what is their requirement, whether they need a microbiologist for quality control, whether they need a microbiologist for production purpose. Accordingly, you can study and go and visit over there, or you can give very plain interview over there. That is the best thing. As per skill, I'm telling you, already told you that autoclave, hot air one, or dry heat sterilizer, pH meter, spectrophotometer, and how this LAF means laminar airflow handling and microscope handling. This basic thing you should know very properly when you are going for an interview or when you are applying for any industry. And the last point I'm coming to you, for that is the interview preparation. I see, I took on various interviews for various from longer time. In rural area, what we found that people are not taking interview very seriously. They should be well dressed. There should be clean shaved. If girls are there, there should be hair proper. Hair dressing is should proper. Then they should come with a proper resume. They might have been taken some poster presentation and all those things they are taking. If they are taking participation in it, they should come with all documents and all original documents. Never hand over your original document to company, but at the time of interview you can show your documents. It is very important, because many times I found that the candidate is suitable for us, but at the time of appointment he don't have his proper documents, and that make us somewhat problematic. As sir told, Deshmukh sir told you, there is a large scope in this field. You can see my resume. I worked in agriculture, microbiology first, then I shifted my career into pharmaceutical as a quality control pharmaceutical microbiologist. Then again I shift my career from that to biopharma field in serum. So you can make a switch over anytime. The basic knowledge of fermentation, sterilization and media preparation you should have with you. As I told you, the scheduleum, you should know very well the scheduleum. Once you know the scheduleum, the all pharmaceutical and biopharmaceutical industries are open to you. That is the key word. And I also request the professors and the dignitary of academic peoples that we should add the Indian pharmacopoeia's work or scheduleum's work in a curriculum activity, so that this microbiologist, budding microbiologist, can develop themselves for working in a pharmaceutical industry. Because this is the biggest industry currently. We are the leader, means in the world we are the leader now. This is the proud thing that we producing this much quantity of vaccines and this much quantity of drug. Okay, now, one more thing is that biodiagnostic is the new science emerging right now. Because you know, all this corona comes, and after that each and everybody have his theories and all those things. So we need a scientist to analyze such a new things. We need a microbiologist for that, we need a virologist, we need a bacteriologist for that. And this year, in future, I am thinking that the bio warfare is the more predominantly come into picture. So that the governments and all other authorities should be prepared for such type of warfares and other things. That field we can do a lot of work. Fast tracking vaccine production. Now you see, it is very in these days. The vaccine production was done in a very less time, because it took only hardly 1.5 years. Previously it took near about 6 to 7 years. So this is the new emerging field also where we can work. So, and for that production also, the vaccine production unit, and as a various dignitary already told you, the we can go in a startup. Yes, you can go startup. From 2016, I am successfully running this unit. Have major product of biofertilizer, biopesticide, and other biofungicides also. So, in anyone can go in a food industry also, or other industry where you can work very beautifully.